we've been talking about the statistics all month. Pancreatic cancer kills 94% of people who are diagnosed.
But tonight, 4029's Lauren Limerick has a story of hope from a local woman who survived the almost always deadly disease.
I had a lot of acid reflux. I was having issues with food. My back was killing me. And now looking back, I know those are all symptoms. The doctors kept telling me I was overweight, I needed to go on a diet, that because of my age, there was nothing major wrong.
Rogers resident Jennifer Baker was 29 when she found out she had pancreatic cancer. There are no early detection methods for the cancer, and then once you're diagnosed, treatment is limited.
He came in and he handed me a picture of what your pancreas looks like. And he said, we have found a mass on the head of your pancreas. And I don't want you to go home and look this up on the internet. Just go home. We're going to set you up with an appointment to see a specialist in St. Louis. That, it was like nothing happened after that. The world just came to a standstill.
Jennifer was diagnosed with the same type of pancreatic cancer Apple's Steve Jobs had earlier this year. I asked her if she thought celebrities who go public with their cancer help raise awareness.
I do, and at the same time, I think maybe it hurts it a little bit because people look at the fact that they had all that money and they couldn't cure it. So maybe they automatically go, well, there's nothing I can do. You know, I'm going to end up just like they did, and that's not the case.
4 months after her diagnosis, she had surgery.
He came in and said that they were able to get everything, and the tumor was encapsulated, which means that it had not spread, so I did not have to go through chemo or radiation.
She has been cancer-free for 4 years and 8 months.
The doctor says, oh, you're just overweight, you need to lose weight, or, you know, it's just acid reflux, a lot of people have it, it's not a big deal. If you know something is wrong, and you know when something is really wrong with you, push. Tell them you're not going to take that. If it takes getting a second or a third opinion, do it.
She says she cherishes the life she nearly lost.
I'm trying not to cry. There was a time that may not have happened. If I had listened to my doctor and I had not pushed and pushed, I would not be here to experience being a grandparent. So it's wonderful.
Lauren Limerick, 4029 News.
That is amazing. Mm-hmm. If you or a loved one has pancreatic cancer, you're not alone. The Pancreatic Cancer Action Network works to advance research and, of course, support.
Yeah, we've posted a link to their website on our website. Just go to 4029tv.com.